to my YouTube channel. Myself Neha and name of my YouTube channel is Let's Talk About Accounting. In this channel, you will get to learn all about Tally, Accounting, GST and Taxation. You will also get in-depth knowledge of Tally ARP 9 with GST to meet the accounting requirements of the industry. We not only teach the concept, but also help you learn how you can practically implement those concepts in your day-to-day accounting process with practical examples and entries in Tally. So please do subscribe my YouTube channel for more accounting related videos. Now let's start with our today's topic. Our today's topic is how to create sales entry in Tally by using voucher method. Okay, in my previous video, I explained you about the purchase method. Same way, in my current video, I will explain you about the sales entry, means when you sell anything, how you have to make that entry and that too by voucher method. I would like to tell you that in sales, there are two methods. One is voucher method, another is invoice method. Voucher method is used mostly 99% by service industry, means the persons who don't maintain their inventory or don't maintain their stock. While invoice method is used by manufacturers, traders, it means the persons or the entities which maintain stock or which maintain inventory, they are using invoice method. So today we will study about the voucher method. So it's very simple. You don't have to maintain any stock. Simply you have to sell the things which you intend to sell. Okay, so let's start with how to create sales entry in Tally ERP 9 by using voucher method. To have a clear understanding, I have framed one example for you. My example is ABC Limited sold goods to Mr. B for a value of rupees 15,000. Okay, so ABC Limited sold goods. So I sold goods, and to whom I sold? To Mr. B for a value. So the price, or yes, the price is rupees 15,000. So I sold goods for rupees 15,000 to Mr. B. So in this case, I will debit customer account, and customer in this case is Mr. B, and Mr. B is my sundry debtor. I will debit customer's account and I will credit sales account or the goods sold, because just to understand that in profit and loss, sales account comes under credit side of profit and loss account. So sales will come under credit side, so we have to credit sales, and as our customers is our debtors, so you have to debit the customer account. Okay, it's a very simple entry to understand. Now let's go to Tally. This is my Tally navigation page. As you know that we have to make entries by accounting vouchers, I will press accounting voucher. In my previous videos, I told you about the payment method, receipt method, purchase method. The shortcut key for payment, if you want to open the payment voucher, you have to press F5. For receipt, it is F6. Yes. For purchases, it is F9. And for sales, it will be now F8. So remember, for sales, a shortcut key in Tally is F8. Now, this voucher, it is known as invoice method. I don't want this, like number of item, quantity, rate. How you will identify that whether this voucher is voucher method or invoice method? When the quantity and rate comes, it means that it is your invoice method. If you are not maintaining stock, then there is no need for you to maintain quantity as well as rate. So what you have to press? You have to simply press as voucher. When you press as voucher, this will be about your voucher method in sales. Okay. Now we have to make the entry. First of all, change the date. Our shortcut key to change the date is F2. We will assume that this transaction happened on 1st April. Okay, yes. So my date has been edited. Now reference number. Reference number is also known as invoice number. When you take anything from any party, or you take the invoice, or you give the invoice, always the reference number has been mentioned over there. Okay, so in your sales also, when you sell anything to any party, there will always be invoice number. Okay, and it will always be in a systematic order. Okay, so I will assume that this is my first sales of this current year. So I will give reference number as 1. You can edit anything like 1, 20, 21. Like financial year, first transaction, or the first sale of financial year 2021. Okay, now buy. Buy means what? Okay, what was my accounting entry? Customer account debit to. Yes, goods sold account. So customer account is coming to buy side. So buy means debit. So to whom I will debit? Yes. What was my party's name? Mr. B over here. So I will write Mr. B. Mr. B, if I'm selling anything to any party or to my customer, they will always be my sundry debtors. Okay. Now next, yes, you don't have to enter anything. Even if you don't maintain anything, like you can maintain, you can give PAN number of that customer, you can mention their country, state, you can provide the bank details, anything you can provide. Now I'm simply accepting my ledger. Okay. You can mention the address also because it is necessary for your GST transactions. Okay. State is Maharashtra, the sales tax registration number. Okay. So debit. How much sales I have made? I have made sales of ₹15,000. So I will enter that amount. Okay. Now what is this on account or anything? So I can press anything, advance, against receipt, new reference, against reference, new reference on account. Now here I will assume that I am making this on account only. Just I am making sales to that particular party. Okay. So two will be my goods sold. If you know that what specific goods you are selling, then you can write the name of that goods sold, like computer sold or cement sale or steel sale, anything you can mention. Okay. Goods sold will always come under the group as sales account because we are selling that transaction. Okay. Yes. Simply don't accept anything if you are a non-GST registered person and you are not providing any GST details in your bill. There is no need for you to accept anything after your group bifurcation. Okay. Simply accept the ledger created. Okay. Goods sold. Bus. This is the entry. Give proper narration, being goods sold, yes, and accept. For accept, again you have to press Y or enter. I will press enter and yes, my sales voucher has been accepted. Now how I will cross check that whether my sales entry has been saved? So go to profit and loss account. Sales account will always come under your trading account or your profit and loss account. Go to sales account on the credit side. Press enter and you can see over here goods sold. Okay, in the month of April, I have made goods sold to Mr. B. Everyone is clear? Okay, next, again, the second transaction or the second effect will go to current assets in the sundry debtors. And in that, I can see Mr. B in the month of April. I have sold goods to Mr. B. So this is the second effect of your transaction, which you have made in sales. So in this way, we have completed our sales entry. Remember, this is just a voucher entry and I have not made any bifurcation about GST. In my coming videos, I will explain you that in voucher method, how you can enter your GST details if your supplier has provided to you or you have to provide to your customer. Okay, this is a plain, simple sales entry. This is just for your knowledge. If you are a beginner or you are learning tally for first time, so this is just the knowledge or the experience which I want to provide to you. So it's a plain sales entry. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel so that I can explain you more about sales purchase and that too with GST explanation. Okay. So thank you for watching my video. Do subscribe my YouTube channel so that you would be able to learn all the topics which I have mentioned about my YouTube channel, like tally, accounting, GST, income tax. Thank you so much for your support.